अस्सलामुअलैकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहु। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू दिस ऑनलाइन लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ हेरा इंग्लिश स्कूल स्टैंडर्ड 9th। सो इन साइंस 2 वी हैव फिनिश्ड विद चैप्टर नंबर 6, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ प्लांट्स। एंड नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद चैप्टर नंबर 7, energy flow in an ecosystem. So first we'll understand what is an ecosystem. An ecosystem is a community of living things that interact with each other and with physical world. Dear students, whatever we see in our environment, whether it's living beings or non-living beings, all together contribute to our ecosystem. Then the plants and animals within each ecosystem interact with each other, and the non-living elements of the ecosystem like climate, precipitation and soil. So as I said you, living things and non-living things which are present in our environment, they are part of ecosystem. Ecosystem can be very small, such as puddle or under a rock. It can also be as big as an ocean or a desert. So if you try to understand what exactly the ecosystem is, ecosystem can be, you know, a piece of rock as well. Or if you select any lake, okay, around you, or a pond around you. So if you want to understand this particular part of the environment, which we call as ecosystem, what factors are affecting this ecosystem? Now those factors, as I said, you can be living things or non-living things. The balance of an ecosystem is important. All living things must work together to provide a good living environment. For example, if there is not enough water, plants and animals will die and the ecosystem will not exist. So this point helps us to understand how important all the factors in ecosystem are. The example which is given here says that water, which is a non-living thing, but living things like plants and animals, they are totally dependent on the part of the ecosystem, that is water. So every part of the ecosystem helps to maintain balance, and they are very important for it. Now some more examples if you can give to understand ecosystem. An ecosystem can be a desert, it can be Arctic tundra, rainforest, ocean, African savanna, swamp. These are different examples. Now see, this ecosystem consists of different parts in it. The different players who are playing role in ecosystem. You will understand these all one by one. The first is producer. What is producer? A living thing that can make its own food. We know that. Who are they? They are plants, they are trees, they are flowers. All of them have green pigment, that is chlorophyll, and with the help of chlorophyll they carry out the process of photosynthesis, which help them to prepare their own food. So these are the part of our ecosystem which we call them as producer. Why? Because they prepare their own food and they take it by for themselves, as well as we eat them. So we are totally dependent on producers. So where we fall under consumer, the second part of our ecosystem. Okay, so as I said you, these all are the players of ecosystem. So first, as we have seen now, they are producers. The second comes consumers. A living thing that gets its food from eating other living things. Example, polar bear eating a fish, a bird eating a berry, a zebra eating grass. So all of them are called consumers. Okay, so these consumers are also further divided into primary consumers, secondary consumers, tertiary consumers are called as apex consumers. So the different levels of consumers which we will see in further part of the lecture. Then there is one more important player which is taking very important role in our ecosystem called as decomposers or saprophytes. A living thing that break down other living things to get nutrients and energy, they are called as decomposers. So word itself says, what is decomposer? Things which decompose the other things. For example, vultures, they eat dead animals. Worms and beetles, they eat dead decaying plants. So what they do? They decompose them. They eat dead bodies. When they decompose them, all the nutrients present in those dead bodies, they goes back to the soil, to our nature. And this is how the whole cycle continues. Then we'll also need to understand the term called as population. What is population? A group of living things that live in the same place at the same time. A group of living things that live in the same place at the same time is called as population. For example, many penguins live in the Arctic. Many elephants live in the African savanna. So what they're called as? They're called as population. Because they are the same animals living at the same place, so we'll call them as population of those animals. Then there comes community. This term means what? When different populations live together in the same habitat and interact with each other. Now see here, different populations, okay, group of animals of different species, they live together in the same habitat. Habitat means the same place, the living place or the dwelling place, and they interact with each other. For example, elephants, giraffes, and zebra all live together in savanna. So this is called as community of animals. Now, other important part of our ecosystem is called as abiotic factor. Okay, what is abiotic factors? Any non-living organisms in an ecosystem are said to be abiotic component of that ecosystem. Okay, now it can be, you know, all the non-living things. Examples are given here: sun, the clouds, or the rocks, rain. All this fall under abiotic factors. Then biotic factor, the biotic component of our ecosystem, any living organism in an ecosystem, whether it's big animal or microorganism, plants, okay, so all these contribute together as biotic components of our ecosystem. Now there comes food chain. Now as the name of the chapter is energy flow in an ecosystem. So how do we get energy? The word energy is saying you something, that energy we get from the food which we eat. So different animals, different organisms present in our ecosystem, they are linked together through this food chain. So food chain shows what eats what in an ecosystem, which organism eats what in an ecosystem, and how it contribute in the flow of energy in that ecosystem. Now for example, you can see here, a lion eats deer. Okay, see the arrow, how the arrows are pointed. A lion eats deer, okay, and deer eats the vegetative part of our ecosystem. So how they are linked together? So if this shows what food chain is of all about. Food chain is the flow, how each organism is linked to another organism and how they are helping this food chain to get completed. Then if you see another example over here, food chain of an owl which is eating mouse, the mouse is eating insect, and then insect eat plants. So this is how they are linked together. Now you can see plant is termed as over here producer, right? Insect depends on plant, it's called consumer. Which type of consumer? Herbivore type of consumer. Herbivore are those group of organism which eat only vegetation part of our ecosystem. Okay, then mouse, it's called also as consumer, but which type of consumer? Omnivore, because it eats the herbivores part of organism, right? And then owl is called another apex consumer, the tertiary consumer, which eat mouse. It's called carnivore, which eat only flesh. So this is food chain. Okay, this is how they are linked together, producers, consumers. So they are, this is how the whole part of our ecosystems is linked together. Different players of our ecosystem are linked together. Plant being eaten up by insects are being eaten up by mouse, mouse have been eaten up by owl, and then if owl gets died, this decomposer will decompose the body, and again this nutrient will go back to the soil, and then plant will grow over that soil, and this is how the whole food chain is completed. Then there is another term called as food web. What is food web? Now web is something, you know, it's called as network. So a food web consists of all the food chains within a particular system. There can be different food chains which are linked together, helping the flow of nutrients in our surrounding. You can see in the diagram, okay, how these different food chains are linked together. It becomes a network. It's called as food web. So you can also call food web as the network of food chains. Okay. So this term food web is to be understood in an ecosystem. If I give another pictorial representation or the distribution of different consumers in our ecosystem, once again, you can see over the screen what primary consumers are. Primary consumers also called as herbivores. Examples like grasshopper, squirrel, elephant, they are directly dependent on autotrophs, that is producers. Then come secondary consumers, which we call them as carnivores. There's an example like frog, owl, fox, and these consumers use herbivores as their food. Okay, so secondary consumers are dependent on primary consumer. Primary consumers are dependent on producers. Okay, then comes the third one, apex or top consumers. These are carnivores which only eat fleshes. Okay, how you can identify carnivores? Carnivores can be identified by their nails. They have sharp nails, they have sharp teeth. Okay, the teeth like canines. Okay, pointed teeth like tiger, lion. These consumers use herbivores and carnivores as their food. No other animal feeds on top consumers as they are at the top level. Okay. And then omnivores are mixed consumers like human beings, bear, they feed on herbivores and carnivores. So this is how the different consumers, you know, of our ecosystems are divided depending on the habit of eating. Now in this diagram as well, this food chain also help us to understand. You can see how the whole chain gets completed. The grass which grow due to sunlight and process of photosynthesis, this grass being eaten up by grasshopper, then grasshopper can be called as primary consumer. Okay, and here grass becomes producer. Then comes frog eats grasshopper, it becomes secondary consumer. Then comes snake eats, you know, frog. Okay, so it becomes what? Tertiary consumer. Okay, and then eagle eats snake, it becomes apex consumer. Okay, and then when eagle get die, so here the organisms, okay, decomposers, they eat the dead body of the eagle, and those nutrients of this organism given back to soil, and this is how the whole chain comes. Now here if one should understand what happened if any one of this, okay, suppose frog disappeared from our nature, so what will happen? It will disturb the balance of ecosystem. Who will eat grasshopper? Okay, and then the population of grasshopper will rise. Here the snakes, there is no frog in our ecosystem, the snake population will decrease. Okay, and that ultimately will deprive the food presence of food for eagles or the top consumers. So this how if any of these, you know, part of the consumer get disturbed, then the whole ecosystem get disturbed. Okay, so I hope you have understood this part of this chapter. Whatever we have discussed today, let me recall you, we have discussed about ecosystem, then we have discussed about different consumers present in our ecosystem, then you can see again here, and then what is food chain, what is food web. So I hope you have understood up till here, inshallah. Next time we'll discuss about the further part topic of this chapter. So by the time you read this part, and inshallah we'll meet. Time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.